I think that the emergence of drones is the most exciting thing to happen to aviation since 1903. So when people start to unbox their first drone, everybody is incredibly excited, which is really cool, and that's that magic that you want to keep. But the other aspect of it is that you need to understand that these are aircraft. You know, they're aircraft operating within the National Airspace System. And because that's the case, there's some certain things you need to do.
The biggest thing that we want people who are going to operate a drone to be aware of is that drones are aircraft, and aircraft are very highly regulated. If they know that much, they can go find the rules. If we talk about specific rules, we want them to remember to keep the aircraft in sight while they're flying it. We want them to not fly over people because it's an object that could hurt somebody if it falls out of the sky. And we want to keep them away from airports, heliports, hospitals, which have heliports, because we don't want a drone to interact with an aircraft that's flying normally in the airspace.
There's a great website, dronezone.faa.gov is the best place to go. It's where you can register your drone. So you've gotten your drone, you've gotten out of the box, you've registered it with the FAA. Unfortunately, you're not quite done. Wherever you want to fly, it's important to make sure that you're flying within compliance of the rules of that jurisdiction. Definitely research. It basically boils down to don't be that guy. Don't fly over 400 feet above ground level. Don't fly over critical infrastructure. Don't fly over people. Don't fly at night. Don't fly in adverse weather. Things like that.
One of the neat things about this explosion in drone technology is it kind of paralleled the explosion in smartphone technology. And so there's apps that allow you to do that flight planning on your smartphone, right there on site before you take off.
The one that I personally use is airmap.io. And this is where we are at the Minnesota DOT offices here in Oakdale. We're clear to fly. We have the green triangle down in the right-hand corner, so we should be good to go. Because drones are considered aircraft, you by extension are considered a pilot. And as a pilot, you need to make sure that the airspace is clear. So traditional pilots, they have maps and charts and very expensive websites that they can go to. As a drone pilot, there's a multitude of apps that you can just download. Open them up, it's connected to the GPS in your phone, and it'll tell you yes or no, I can fly or I can't fly today.
Those apps will show you, for example, whether you are inside the controlled airspace associated with an airport. Some of them will show you the limits, geographic limits of state parks and national parks where you're not going to be able to fly.
If there's a temporary flight restriction. So if there's a game at the stadium, if there's a government official coming into town, the FAA will place restrictions on flight in that airspace, and those apps are a great resource to making sure that you're flying within compliance.
You can find those apps on the Google Play Store or the Apple Store. You would want to do search for drone flight planning or drone airspace.
Taking off with one of these drones is very simple. You literally use the user interface, and it takes off by itself up to an altitude of 5 or so feet. And then from there, you just go flying. Is this really necessary is the biggest question that new drone pilots ask. And to this I say, yeah, it is. To you, it's a flying selfie stick. It's a great way to see some place that you know and love from a great different perspective. You get some incredible pictures, share some really good times with your friends, right? And that's great. And everybody wants that for that to continue. The other aspect you need to think about when you're thinking about this, though, is that there's other aircraft up there. You're not the only one in that sky. All the fun stops for drones the moment that somebody in a real airplane gets hurt from one of them. And so what we're really doing by encouraging safe, responsible use, by encouraging compliance, is making sure that everybody can have that safe operating environment, whether you're doing it professionally or as a hobbyist, because that's the only way that this can continue.